Welcome to yet another episode of Super Steam and Play Zero Truck Simulator 2. And we are in Netherlands, and our truck is damaged. And I believe we are sleepy. But before going to sleep, let's first turn on some radio. And you know what? It's a kicking country. Well, I hope we'll hear kicking country pretty soon. And we do. Okay. Okay. Okay, so as you can see, we are normally sleepy. So before accepting next job, I'm actually going to repair my vehicle, and not only that, I plan to sleep. And where should we go? What do you say, huh? What location should be our next? It's a really a great experience and a huge honor to travel across the Europe. Have the opportunity to see all these new places which I wouldn't be otherwise able to see. Wow, lot of cars. Let's try not to damage our truck even more than it already is. Tough truck dealer discovered. Okay, let's check the price. Truck repairs, €2,000. Well, not a huge deal, I expected more, so this is good. Paint shop, should we change the color? Actually, we already bought custom color. Or not. I believe we bought custom color. Didn't we? No. I want a blue truck. Perfect. No! It took more of my money! Oh god, €5,000. I thought I already bought that shit. Otherwise I wouldn't pay for more. Oh god. Let's sleep and forget about this mess. Perfect. Now let's check the jobs. Job market. Freight market. We are in Netherlands. Oh! Should we go to Great Britain again? I don't think so. No. I want to go somewhere. I guess we will go to Great Britain again after all. So what? Shit happens. But first, we need to pick our trailer. I want to see my GPS. Yep, we need to abandon this parking place and go. This is pretty close. And last time I visited Great Britain, it was on my last channel, Angry Go Runs. I had a lot of speed offenses, and I was so confused because of different rules. But I guess I'll have to do it again. Yep. Going to Dower. What's my cargo? Wait! Oh god, I'm driving cars! For the first time in this game, I'll transport cars. Which is a huge honor. A huge honor if you ask me, for some reason. And we got the new blue truck. Pretty expensive color. Okay. Let's drive these cars with huge responsibility, and let's do our best that each car is not scratched and pretty fine, and everything should be cool. So, as you can see, I'm rested, we got enough gas, everything should be fine. Everything should be fine now, it all depends on my concentration. And this is going to be a long trip because it says 566 kilometers! Woo! Oh god! And we are not driving a pink truck of love, anymore. Because I'm a huge fan of sky blue color, dark blue, any kind of blue, and red is my favorite, but pink, I'm not a huge fan of pink color, despite it represents a lot of interesting things, you have to admit. And of course I'm in love, so having a pink truck seems appropriate for me. But despite being in love, I believe this color, this beautiful blue color, can also represent love, if you ask me. So it's just a little change for us who sit inside this truck. And I know my baby is watching this, so thank you, baby. And for every other human being or a cat, meow, who watches this, every single one of you, of course, every viewer of this video is sitting here with me, and it feels so good to have you. And this can be a long travel, and as you can see, a lot of clouds are there, and it can expect some raining, but we are ready and driving like crazy. And we'll find some subject to talk about, as we simply always do. And what do you wanna talk about today? Okay, need to be careful here. Because we repaired our truck, everything is perfect. I would like some rain, actually. And I hope we'll travel across decent road. And not some forbidden countryside. And oh god, look at the sun, look at the fields, it's amazing. Well, because I mentioned my girl and generally relationship, maybe we can talk about relationships, but not only relationship between you and your girlfriend, or you and your boyfriend if you're a girl, or you and a female cat if you are a male cat, or you and a male cat if you are a female cat. It can be also not only a love relationship, it can be any kind of relationship between two beings, even human male cat relationships and human female cat relationships, which we will discuss, of course, in this episode. What exactly is a relationship between two beings? How can you define that two human beings, or human and a cat, and cat blah blah, are in a relationship. Does that mean that they communicate? Does it mean that they share some interests, some happenings in life? Does that mean that they do something together? Does it mean they share some love? What does actually mean to be in relationship with someone? Well, actually, I have no idea. You cannot expect me to know everything. I have no freaking idea. I'm just a driver. I'm a stupid driver and I need to focus on my cargo. I don't know why you keep asking me about life, especially you who sit there. What? Wow, what a beautiful place! Oh God! You lucky Dutch people! I'm a huge fan of bridges. Anyways. Relationship is relationship. Calm down, guys. It's nothing special. Of course it is, but it depends on you how special it can be. Or because if you have some boring and uninteresting relationship with someone, and that's like not honest relationship, it's not based on making other a person happy, then it's not relationship I want to talk about. There are many types of relationships. Many. And the more deep and honest relationships you have, the happier you'll be in your life. That depends, of course, on healthy communication with your parents, if you have them. That means healthy and normal conversations, communication, interactions between your friends. If you have them, you can also have amazing relationship with your cat. If you pet your cat, take care of your pet and stuff. And of course, you can have an amazing love relationship with a person you really care about. If you truly, and I mean truly, care about the person. But what are the benefits of relationship, you may ask? Because you can notice today in real life that most people tend to be with others just because of interests, right? They share similar interests. You'll notice that mostly in companies where you have colleagues, people tend to get easily jealous, you know? They don't want to share your happiness. They'll be jealous if you are successful, because you compete in same Can you move your freaking green car? So, where was I? The thing is, competing is healthy, but only when it's like pure, clean competition, without evil desires, without jealousy, without blackness inside your heart. Being surrounded with people that share with you some healthy and deep relationship gives you their energy, and of course you give them your energy, and you are constantly happy. You have so much gas, it's like a track. For example, let's just say this road is a relationship. It's relationship between destination and starting place. That can be some company where I pick my trailer and stuff. Let's say that the relationship is this road. And as you can see, we got the truck. And this truck can represent all the things we do in the relationship. How we behave, how we talk, how much we care. You can have a better truck, you can have a cheaper truck, you can have a better cargo. That represents lot of things you do in your relationship. But if you really care about someone and someone really cares about you, then building relationship will be similar to this travel. You will sit here with your partner, metaphorically speaking, of course. You'll share the life together. For example, this road. You are on the same path. Because you talk, you communicate, you can be in love with one each other. So, there are many roads in life and many people, many possibilities, but you and someone can share the same road. Now, the longer the road, also the deeper the relationship is, because all these cities in Euro Truck Simulator can represent different personalities, and some are far, some are close. I know a lot of people on the internet, but unfortunately I won't be able to see them ever in my life, maybe, only in afterlife. Because they have their own roads. I have my own road, but people really close to you can share the same road with you and sit in the same truck, do a lot of similar stuff. I'm talking about pure normal relationship without jealousy. Because if I got my energy and I want to share with you guys, my energy can represent, my truck can represent my energy. And you are not here to be jealous on what I accomplished in my life or something. You are here to be happy for me. And I will do the same thing for you. That's how we are supposed to behave in real life. Admire one each other's accomplishments and point on some mistakes we do and really care about one each other. So when you are in love with someone, that's really unique and special because that road can be the longest one. And what happens when you are in a relationship with someone who doesn't fit your life, who isn't like your soulmate? What happens then? Traveling can become boring because when you love someone, end goal is like marriage. Let's say mostly it is. And it's a long road. That means you are probably going to share a life with people, person you love. So that means, of course, it's a really long road. And you want to make it interesting. You want to listen to a good music inside the truck. You want to build a good truck. You want to make sure that your path is going easy and well and everything is fine and everybody is happy. But if your partner, male partner if you are a female, or a female partner if you are a male, I will not discuss gay stuff now, I don't have anything against them, it's just that let's keep that subject for some other time. Let's say you and your girlfriend don't fit one each other well. The trip won't go well. She'll observe, of course, you can admire stuff through the windows. But she won't be truly happy inside your truck. No. She will be like, my path lies somewhere on some other road, in some other truck. But thankfully, thank God, I honestly believe I finally managed to find a girl of my dreams. Of course, it's just the beginning, but she and me share the same road, sitting in the same truck, dealing with the problems, dealing with the crashes if we find some, and together discussing about beautiful world, beautiful road, happy that we sit in the same truck. You get the metaphor? That's how I connect relationships with Euro Truck Simulator 2. As you can see, Euro Truck Simulator 2 helps me a lot to increase my inner knowledge, to increase my knowledge about people, about stuff, just by driving on this road. And this truck and I are carrying the same freaking cargo. Woo! Which is actually pretty cool, if you ask me. We are taking care of lot of cars which should be transferred to Great Britain, because people in Great Britain need to drive cars. So, yeah, playing Euro Truck Simulator is not only like enjoyable for my eyes and fun, it gives me more, it gives me depth, it gives me something that other games will never be able to give me. Except maybe Robot Vacuum Simulator 2013, of course, and Farming Simulator, and also Batman, and Cinemora, and also lot of other games. Wow, look at this! We got the crossover between Euro Truck Simulator 2 and Train Simulator 2013, and the beautiful moon on top of the sky, and everything is going perfectly fine so far. This is a really long trip, so I'll probably have to take a nap during my way, and we'll probably have to refill my gas a bit. Oh god, I'm still unhappy because I spent freaking 5,000 euros on paint job. It's like freaking expensive. I know a guy who can do it for 1,000 euros. 5,000 euros is way too freaking expensive. But unfortunately, there isn't a guy who will do that for me in this game, because there is no Croatia and the guy is in Croatia. Oh my dear. Check the sky, check the atmosphere, check the peace, check the harmony. Guys, don't let the bad memories take over you. No, I know some of you had problems in your past. I really do. I mean, haven't we all? It's just that take the best from those. They are those fragments that are really nice and worth remembering. And put them on your road. Take those amazing moments from the past. And always smile when you remember them. And forget about bad ones. And let the bad ones just make you and keep you stronger, more resistant. But keep the good ones to enjoy, to smile more. There are amazing things I can take out from my ex-relationships. And it's all a long road, and there were parts on my road, in my life, that were not that good, that had some obstacles, some crashes. But what happens? You simply repair your truck, which means you rebuild your own. You rebuild your own image, you rebuild yourself, you become stronger, you change your image even a bit, and you are good to go. It's a long way, it's a huge life, guys. I mean, you can die, I can die tomorrow. Any one of us can die. But we are not supposed to be afraid of dying. No. It's a trip, it's a movie, and let's see how it ends. And it's always good to have people around you, to share with you your life. So don't be unhappy if you don't have many relationships, like with people, when you know that some of them, or maybe most of them, are jealous or evil. People can be evil. Today, they tend to be evil. In that case, be happy to have less relationships, but it's hard to truly be able to judge who is bad, who is good, because you need to have a lot of experience with people. And I just hope you'll be happy and you'll share good relationships, more good relationships, less bad relationships. Better to have none relationships than bad relationships. Remember that. Better to be solo than have a bad girlfriend, for example. Better to be a single cat than be a cat who has a bad female cat in relationship. It's like, bah, 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 bah. That's not a good relationship. But thanks God, as I already talked about my girl, my new girl, she approached me, thankfully, and we met fun each other, and what can I say, it went so fast, but sometimes you know it's it. When you care about her, she cares about you. And do you know how I really know that she's the one? She likes Euro Truck Simulator too. What other reason I need, actually? What other reason I need? Imagine a life who supports you while you play Euro Truck Simulator 2. I mean... Wow. In a couple of years we'll probably have Euro Truck Simulator 4. But till then, I'll just focus on Euro Truck Simulator 2. And I'm not sure how many episodes I'm going to make in Season 1 of Superstemon Plays Euro Truck Simulator 2. That can be in one episode, that can be in two episodes, the ending, of course, of Season 1. I'm not sure. Season 2, Season 1, whatever. But I know I'll play Euro Truck more and more and more, because as some of you already know, I abandoned my old channel. It's not about popularity anymore. It's not about who will watch this video. Those of people who watch this video, you are so special to me. Thank you for sitting here chatting with me. I mean, I'm chatting, you listen. But it's not anymore about popularity. It's personal. It's like I'm rebuilding my soul. Let me focus there. Okay. I'm rebuilding my soul, my heart. I'm enjoying this trip. I'm listening to Kicking Country. I have privilege to be observed, to be watched by you guys and cats and girls and stuff. So something's changed, definitely. Something's changed. It's a different, really. I can say I became smaller, but in good way. You know, remember me for those who observed me while I was angry go round. I was very popular back then. People recognized me everywhere, especially online, in chats, on Hotshot GG stream and stuff. It was so good, and everything was so great. Girlfriend came and stuff. Everything was so cool. But let me focus, fix my focus there. As soon as your popularity goes a bit down, you'll get easily abandoned by people. That's normal, of course. You'll get abandoned by people who mostly just search for entertainment, and of course, once you become boring to them, they'll just go for another entertainment. Once that entertainment becomes boring for them, they'll go for another entertainment. That's normal circle. That's how it goes today. That's also how it goes with relationships today. People can be with you while you are a bit interesting for them, because you are new, you look fresh, and your ideas look new to them. But soon, they can become that can become boring to them, and they will leave. That can happen, of course, in with subscribers, that can happen with love relationships. One partner can become simply bored of another and will find another one. That's all cool and stuff, that's life. But I can hope, and we can all hope, that person or people who leave away from us can find their happiness and fulfillment somewhere else. That's what we can hope, that's what we can pray for. And also focus on a bit on the present, which means admire the moments, those special moments we have today, and let me fix my focus there. And for example, in my case with a new girlfriend, in my case with a new channel, in my case with a new blue truck, or in your case with lot of other interesting things, guys. Receiving your messages in YouTube inbox about how you did something good makes me abnormally proud of you. You can say to yourself, some super steaming in Croatia who is not anything special is proud of me, like I really am, guys. I'm proud of you. Do something nice, share the life, love, share the good faith, goodwill, and that's all I need. I'm not asking you to, you don't need to like my videos, you don't need to do anything. Just, you can abandon my channel, but just be good people. Just be good people, guys. That's what matters, not how much I'm going to be popular on some channel or not. Understood? Just be nice. Share some love, guys. Increase the power of relationships. And if people around you are not lights, you should be the light. Don't say like everybody around me is bad. No, that's not what I want to hear. I want to see you shining. I want to see you be a light. That's my desire. Fulfill it, guys. Fulfill it. Also, you can't. Thank you. 108 kilometers away from our destination. Soon we'll get sleepy. As you can see, our bed is becoming more and more blue. But so far, this trip is going pretty well. Oh! We are supposed to go to Great Britain now. That's cool. That's really cool. Okay. Let me see. What am I supposed to do now? Okay. No, I'm not supposed. Okay, so I can. No? Can I turn here? This is not for trucks. It says no trucks. This one is for trucks. This one is definitely for trucks. I'm going here. Lights on. Okay, I got a huge cargo. Need to be careful. Perfect. And I see one truck. This will be my position. Okay, enter. I'm supposed to go to Dawa. Embark. I have to pay 300 freaking euros. I just traveled. I think I'm done with. I just crashed again. Oh God, why? Oh God. We are so close. So close! Let me try to not crash again till I reach my destination. And now we have to be careful. Left side of the road, guys. Left side of the road. Woo! I hope the cars are unscratched. Where is the exit? I believe it's here. Lovely, lovely music. Lovely, lovely, lovely music. Okay. It's the middle of night, actually. It's 3 a.m. Let me fix my focus there. Freaking stupid camera. Freaking stupid camera. But it's good to have a bad focus there, because I look prettier when we have a bad focus there. Okay. Need to stay on the left side. Perfect. And again, we have to turn left. Let's see a sign. Dover. Okay. Well, it's definitely easier to turn. Oh no! Woo! Oh, I forgot I'm in England. Oh God, please forgive me. Please forgive me. Can I go back finally? Perfect. Apologies! Apologies, guys. I forgot I'm in Great Britain. And let me fix my focus there again. Lot of stupid things to take care of. I have problems with the focus in a worst possible situation. Okay, sorry if my focus goes everywhere. But I need to concentrate, guys, and my fellows. As you can see, I already got problems. I always got problems in Great Britain. But one thing I love about Great Britain are freaking Beatles. Freaking Beatles, masters of music. And not only them. I like your, for those who watch this video, if they are from Great Britain, I love your football a lot. Liverpool, You'll Never Walk Alone. Oh goodness, I'll have to sleep in England. It's so weird to drive on this side of the road. But this, if we compare this to relationships, some parts can feel awkward. But you can get used to them. And together with your partner or with someone else, you can manage it. You can do it. You are capable of. You can crash and stuff here and there. But you need to stay focused and enjoy your trip and everything. I say, and I mean, guys and girls and cats, mama, everything is going to be fine. Trust me on that one. I got a good job. I work hard for my money. When it's quitting time, I hit the door running. I fire up my pickup truck and let the horses. You have to be so slow in freaking England. So slow. 30 kilometers per hour. freaking 30 kilometers per hour. This is not a freaking village. It's a big city, for God's sake. Oh God, if this continues, I'll become angry Goran again, angry and stuff. But now I'm super steaming. Okay. What am I supposed to do now? Wait for these two cars to go. Wait for these three cars to go. Can I? Thank you. People, thank you. Thank you. No, I don't want to go to London, at least not yet. Dover. There is our destination, my fellas. And there is a bus full of angry people. Or no, maybe it's empty. Let's see. Maybe there's... Actually, I see people inside. One guy sitting behind. And I see another one inside. That's cool. That's actually pretty cool. Okay, this is my company. Let's see our rating. Wait for me, car, to pass. Excellent. And I'm skilled worker. We earned 18,000 euros. I have to admit you, I'm pretty satisfied. Just in time delivery, that's what we need. Okay guys. Was the huge pleasure again to talk to you, to have you in my truck. Thank you. And we are playing some Euro Truck, driving across the Europe. Let me fix my focus there. Thank you for being with me, and thank you for you being alive, and do nice stuff and be a good fellows. That's what I am asking you. I'll see you next time.